Let's get to another one of your talkback messages here. Again, log on to our free iHeartRadio app. Hit the microphone when you're streaming 96.1 KISS or the Mikey and Bob podcast, and you can make the show. Talkback messages brought to us by One Team Media.
Hey, Rapid Fire Burper here. Just wondering if anyone else remembers whenever Bob took a gas-powered chainsaw into your office and sawed your desk in half.
Well, I mean, he didn't saw the desk in half. All right.
I didn't get through it.
For people who don't know this story, when we first started doing our show, when we were in Green Tree in the big gold DVE building, we're now in Bridgeville, but the first office that we had, it had like a teacher's desk in it. And we were like, this ain't going to fly. Like, get this old wooden desk out of here. We need something else, right?
Heavy, yeah. All wood.
So one morning we had this plan. We didn't tell anybody in the building, and Bob decided to bring in a gas-powered chainsaw and was just going to carve our initials into the desk. That's it. We weren't trying to saw the desk in half. We're just trying to mark the desk. That's
all.
Yeah,
I've never worked a chainsaw before that point, and I had no clue what I was doing.
Gas smell throughout the entire floor.
Yeah, really underestimated.
Smoke in the hallway.
Underestimated that whole part of it.
Yeah, and then I remember our boss's boss ran into the office and was telling you, Bob, shut it off. Shut it off.
As we were live on the on the air. That wasn't a good day.
No, we had a couple meetings after that.
Yeah.
She's got more.
On air. And then I'm pretty sure your boss walked in.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was just wondering.
It was a boss's boss.
Yeah.
Can you guys make a top five of times that you should have been fired, but you weren't? And we don't have to talk about that commercial thing either from like 2 years ago. Oh. But yeah, top five.
Yeah, we don't want to talk about that one. That's my favorite one to talk about. I don't think we have five times that we were almost fired. I don't know. But we do have a couple other situations. Bob ended up in jail one morning during our show. That was probably one where it's like, I don't know, are these guys worth it?
A legit jail trip. Yeah, like handcuffs and everything.
But listen, as we've matured and the show has grown, these were just growing pains. We were just, you know, we were just trying to make a name for ourselves, I guess. But as we've matured and grown, it's like, okay, we, you know.
We took it a little too far sometimes.
Bob was on the side of the parkway, and he was wearing, I don't even know what you were wearing, leather?
I was wearing a leather, like, mini skirt, yeah.
Yeah.
There was some story about men protesting for their rights to, like, cross-dress or dress as women or whatever, so
yeah.
I'm like, I'm in on that.
Okay.
Let's go. So I take it to the side of the parkway right before the tunnels there.
Yeah.
And
apparently you can't just be out there in a mini skirt.
Yeah,
I mean, man or woman, you can't just be on the side by the tunnels just waving the cars and stuff.
Yeah, I didn't last very long out there.
Nope.
State police came and got me.
Got taken to jail and
legit handcuffed.
You were back by the end of the show.
Yeah. Went to jail, got checked in, had to sign a thing that said I would never do it again. Like an official statement. It was crazy. I remember just sitting there, like, in the little thing they put me in, like, in the little room.
Stay off the parkway.
I'm in handcuffs in a leather miniskirt at state police, like, barracks in a little room just thinking, like, oh, man, not only are we in so much trouble, but what if they put me in, like, some type of real jail right now? And I'm dressed in my little miniskirt. No shirt. Nothing to cover me up. So I got out of that, though. They just made me sign something, and I was back by, like, the last couple minutes of the show.
Yeah.
But that was a lot of meetings.
That was an amazing morning. That was close. Once the police get involved, that's usually the time where the station's like, all right, something's got to change here.
Yeah, like, once you end up in handcuffs.
Yeah. So, you know.
It's a red flag.
First couple years, we had some growing pains, but, you know. I don't think we have a top five times that we almost got fired. Those are just a couple off the top of our heads that we can remember. I don't like to think back about those times. Those are different times, man. I don't like to think back about our show during those times. I'm glad that people remember some of that stuff, but like, I don't like to look back on our show. Just moving forward, I don't like to look back on that.